done. Tell me there's no scarf around your throat. Tell me you don't feel it
Roger,
getting tighter.
Please.
Tell me you don't have trouble taking a breath. Tell me that it's
Roger,
all in my imagination
Roger,
now.
Please.
Why? Why? If it doesn't exist, why can't I pull it tighter? Why
Roger,
can't I pull it till there's nothing
stop
left?
Stop it.
What's the harm if there's no scarf?
Roger,
what the
are you
hell
all right?
is he doing here?
What's going on in there?
Get out of here.
Roger, don't worry. I'll get
out
of
the door. Dinah.
You all right?
Why are you screaming like that? Yes, of course I'm all right. But I'm going to probably get nasty notes from the neighbors now thanks to your little tirade.
What do you want?
I want to know why your wife was screaming, Roger.
Don't exaggerate. I wasn't screaming.
It sounded like you were scared to death.
Can you believe him, Roger?
What were you doing to her, Roger?
Matt, relax. We were having a simple disagreement.
I don't buy that.
I don't care.
It's true.
Now, I suggest you get the hell out of here and don't come back.
You know what? I'm not going to leave until I get some answers.
No, I'll tell you what. That's
Amy,
all the
you stop talking.
You get the hell out of here because this is my home.
Okay.
And this is my wife.
All right, Roger. Please. Honey, don't waste your breath. I will take care of him.
Get out.
It's okay.
What was he doing to you in there?
Nothing. Nothing.
It sounded like he was trying to kill you, Dinah.
Well, he wasn't. See? I'm alive and well.
I know you and Hart are into a dangerous game with Roger right now. I know that.
Please, please. It won't be that much longer, okay? Now, don't go running and tell my mother about this. You're gonna blow the whole thing wide open. You know, part of the reason I'm doing this is for her.
She wouldn't want you to put your life on the line, not for her or anyone else,
Listen,
Dinah.
I've got everything covered. Don't make things worse for me by butting your nose in where it doesn't belong.
I know what I heard in there.
No, actually, you don't.
Well, look, I may not have all the details, but I know this game you're playing with Roger has gotten out of control.
Okay. Don't worry. Don't worry. I only play games I can win.
I'm not going to sit back, Dinah, and watch you self-destruct over some misguided...
I mean it, Matt. Just forget it. I'm going to be okay.
Oh, no, you don't. This ends right now.
Oh, you ruined everything. I'm fine.
That's not what it sounded like to me.
I don't care if it sounded like I was getting run over by a Mack truck.
Well, maybe he's going to try that next. What do you think would have happened if I hadn't shown up?
Nothing. Because I had everything under control.
Yeah, well, that's what most abused wives say.
Oh, Matt, believe me, I'm not some battered woman. I don't let someone abuse me without making him pay.
What if he makes you pay first? I don't have to drive your mother down to the morgue so she can ID your body.
Roger can't hurt me. He can't do anything to me he hasn't done already.
Whatever the plan is, let me help you with it.
No.
Then let me take you the hell out of here, Dinah.
I said no.
Dinah, I can protect you. I can fix it so Roger won't give you any more trouble.
You're the only one who's making trouble for me right now. I mean it, Matt. Go. Just leave.
I'm going to call you in 1 hour. You better pick up the phone or I'm coming back.
Okay, fine. Remember, you promised not to tell
my
mother.
You got 1 hour. If I hear anything on the other line that doesn't sound right, I'm going to come back over here, I'm going to bust down the door, and I'm going to take care of Roger.
Don't tell me you're into woman's clothing. Well, your secret's safe with me. I won't tell my mother.
Sorry.
If you want a scarf to accessorize, you're going to have to buy your own. Okay, I'll tell you what. Every season when I clean out my closet, I'll give you first dibs on my hand-me-downs.
Bad joke, Dinah. This isn't funny.
I know it's not. Give it back.
Not until you tell me what's going on.
I just want my scarf.
Something
what's going
weird
on.
Is happening with you and Roger, and I want to know what it is.
As usual, you're being overly dramatic.
After what I heard at your apartment last night, I don't think so. You were upset, and Roger was definitely out of control.
I'm telling you now what I told you then. Everything is fine. I'm handling Roger. When are you going to believe me?
When you start telling the truth.
Just give it back.
I didn't take your scarf, Dinah, and you know that. You stuffed it in my pocket last night when you tried to get rid of me.
Okay. Look, as long as you keep your mouth shut like you promised, and that scarf never sees the light of day again, everything is going to be peachy keen, okay? So can I please have it back? Please. Thank you.
Dinah! Dinah, how are you?
Okay, how much do you know?
Nothing. Nothing, absolutely nothing. I don't know anything. Whatever secret Matt is keeping for you, he's kept.
I gave you my word.
Not that I didn't give him a hard time about it, of course, but I guess it's important to you, so I'm trying to accept that.
Really?
Well, yeah. Really, Daddy always said that I should have more faith in you, and that's what I'm trying to do. So, I should get outside and put these pretty things in the ground. I'll see you both later.
Okay. Who's that? I mean, she looked like my mother, but she sounded more like Carol Brady.
Despite what you think, you're on your mother's mind all the time. She worries about you, she loves you. But she has respect for you. I'm not nearly as laid back about this as she is, probably because I know more than she does. What you're doing, Dinah, is dangerous.
I told you I'm okay.
And I told you I don't want Vanessa hurt, and if something happens to you, she will be.
What? What do you think is going to happen?
I don't know, but if I don't try to stop it, then...
You promised me you wouldn't.
I know I did. And that's why I'm being honest with you now and being upfront. I can't do it anymore. I gotta tell Vanessa.
Oh, no, you don't. If you open up your mouth, I am a dead woman.
That's what I'm trying to prevent.
As long as Roger thinks that I'm his devoted wife, everything is going to be fine.
When guys like Roger lose control, they make their victims feel like it's their fault.
Matt, I am not a victim. When are you gonna get it through your head? This is all my deal. I have got this whole thing organized and orchestrated.
Swear to me Roger hasn't hit you. He hasn't hurt you, that he's not making you do things against your will. Swear to me.
I told you already, no.
I want to believe you. I really do.
Why do you care anyway?
Your family.
I'll let you know as soon as this is all over. Meanwhile, keep your mouth shut, okay?
Okay.
Thank you.
Oh, sweetie, you're not going so soon.
Yeah, I have to.
Yeah. Oh. Well, don't be a stranger, you know, come by. Come by for supper or just no reason, just stop by. I don't believe it. Sit down. This is an absolutely perfect day. I mean, I never thought that I would... Oh, I would ever, ever have my daughter kiss me or hug me or say I love you. She said that, didn't she?
Yeah, she did.
Oh. I don't know how many years I've thought about what a bad mistake I made with her, and how she would never forgive me, and now I feel like anything is possible. Anything is possible.
I'm happy for you.
I just don't understand it, though. I mean, it came completely out of the blue.
Sometimes it happens that way.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I'll take it. No matter how. Let's have her over for supper, okay? On Sunday, would that be good?
Sure, fine.
Okay.
All right, I gotta go. I'll see you later.
Wait, where are you going?
Work. Where else?
Huh? I thought the Fifth Street project was dead as a doornail.
Well, I'm helping Josh put an addition on Ross's house. You know, for the twins.
Oh, right. See? Everything is working out. Ross is going to be a daddy again. You have a new job. And now, if only that daughter of mine would come to her senses and divorce Roger Thorpe, everything would be perfect.
Bye, baby.
Bye, I love you.
Love you, too.
I just all of a sudden realized I always thought I would miss you when things got bad. But, well, a couple of times since you've been gone, I've wanted to run to you and have you comfort me and see you look at me in that patient way. And then, oh, you know. Have your eyes crinkle up and have you say, darling, now, are you really worried about this little thing? Because it too shall pass. And that's exactly what has happened. Because today, my dear, today, my daughter told me that she loves me. Oh. I didn't have to prod her. It was completely spontaneous. So I wish you could be here. Just to see how happy I am. And of course, because you were right, as usual, you always told me. Well, you had faith in Dinah before I would even dare. You told me one day I would look in those beautiful eyes of hers and I wouldn't see anger and I wouldn't see resentment. I would just see love. And it happened.
Talk about Dinah. And no BS this time. Be in to talk about Dinah.
It's been a long day.
I'm not tired.
Don't let the door hit you on the way out.
I don't think you get it, Hart. I'm not going anywhere. Not until you tell me what's going on with Roger and Dinah.
Know how interested you are in every single move that Dinah makes lately?
Watch your mouth.
You came over here, you got in my face, all right? What I do and who I do it with is my business.
She was screaming when I got to their apartment last night.
Who, Dinah?
Roger had her scared. I mean, really scared.
What's going on?
If I hadn't shown up when I did, who knows what he would have done to her.
Hurt her? I mean, did you talk to her?
She told me to mind my own business, and I was gonna screw everything up. She said she had everything under control, but she didn't.
So she wasn't hurt, then?
She said she wasn't, but I don't think she would have told me even if she was. That's why I'm here. I want some answers from you.
I wish I could help you,
but can and you will. Now, what do you and Dinah have planned? Roger is no one to mess with. You know what it looks like to me is you're just hanging Dinah out to dry here.
Do you think I care what it looks like to you?
Well, you better care because Dinah's in trouble.
She told me she had everything under control, that everything was going nice.
Forget about what she said. She lied to you. Now, look, I don't give a damn if this whole thing blows up in your face or not, but I want Dinah out of it now.
Why didn't she just get out of there then, huh?
Maybe Roger wouldn't let her.
Why didn't she tell me this? Damn, man, she could have been hurt.
That's what I've been trying to tell you.
No, I told her not to take any chances, to be cautious. And what did she do? She almost gets herself nailed. Thank God you showed up.
Well, I'll be damned. You do care about Dinah.
Get off my back, William Reardon, huh? Ever since the day you found out I was Roger Thorpe's son, you've been thinking I'm the devil himself. You know, and you were so convinced that I was going to mess things up with Vanessa and your sister. Oh, and now Dinah, too. What's with you, Reardon, huh? What's the deal with this white knight complex, huh?
Are you finished?
And you know what? I'm getting sick of it, okay? Don't you have anything better to do with your time? Why don't you take up stamp collecting, huh?
You know, I thought I had you pegged when I first met you, but I'm beginning to think that maybe you're okay after all.
Why do you even waste your time thinking about me?
Good question.
Why don't you go look in the mirror, Reardon, because you're not so perfect yourself.
You're not hearing what I'm saying. Roger could have hurt Dinah. You know he's capable of it because he doesn't give a damn about her. You know that.
Don't you tell me what I know or what I don't know.
Look, is getting back at your father or whatever the hell it is that you're doing that important? Important enough to see Dinah get hurt?
Man, you are really jumping to conclusions. You know, you're just reaching, Matt.
You know, if you care about her so much, why isn't she here with you instead of with him? Why aren't you protecting her? Why don't you get her to stop?
I would if I could. Matt, you know how Dinah is, huh? She's stubborn, am I right? Have you ever tried to change your mind about anything before?
Yeah, it's like trying to move a cement wall.
Okay, so you know exactly what I'm talking about, okay? I tried to change her mind about what she's doing to Roger, right? She wouldn't listen.
So why don't you blow this whole thing out of the water? Why don't you end it?
You don't even know what it is.
I don't have to know what it is to see that you obviously don't care about it, so why let her go through with it?
Because my father's going to get exactly what is coming to him.
Yeah, but letting Dinah do it is not the way. Get her away from him. Get her away from him as fast as you can.
It's not that simple.
Why not?
Look, at first I thought it was a game. I thought it was something silly, something stupid, okay? But it's not that. It's about Dinah getting back what is hers, her life. Now, Roger hurt her so badly, it's going to be impossible for her to walk away. It's not an option.
There has to be an option.
Also, I hurt her. I used her, okay? The least I can do is to help see this through, and I will.
Okay, if this whole thing's that important to you, let me help. Try shotgun on this plan, whatever it is.
Matt, you don't want any part of this plan.
Obviously I do, or I wouldn't have said that. You can use me, Hart. Another set of eyes.
That's not going to work, Matt.
Why not?
Because I already promised Dinah that I wouldn't go behind her back and get someone else involved, okay? Now, I know exactly what she's going to do if I ask her this. She's going to get mad. She's going to say no.
Okay. All right, I'll tell you what. I hope you know what you're doing. Because if anything happens to Dinah, I'm going to hold you personally responsible.
I swear to you, I swear that I will protect her with my life.